Hey everyone, welcome back. My name is Mandy, the Handmade Homeschooler, and welcome to my channel. If it's your first time here, welcome. I'm so glad you found us in our community. Make sure you hit the like and subscribe button because it really does help me and my channel out. So today we're going to be talking about my Abeka binder. I made one of these last year and the year before, and it has been such a huge help when it comes to all things Abeka and keeping all those pieces together for me and for my kids. So I'm gonna show you what's inside here, but first I'm gonna show you the teacher's manual so you can see some of the things that are inside. We use Abeka Language Arts, and although we use My Father's World as the spine for each individual child for the language arts portion, which you do on a more individual level with your child, we picked Abeka, and Abeka seems to work the best for my kids and their learning style, and they seem to excel the most with it. Now, the way that that works is My Father's World is more of the subjects that you would do together up until about high school. So that would include things like art, music, history, and Bible, and there's all kinds of different components to that spine. But the individualized things like language arts and math would be separate because those need to be on level and on grade level with your child rather than doing that as a collective. So for example, if you have a group that is made up of an eighth grader, a fourth grader, and a third grader, you don't want to use the same math or language arts for all three of them. You want to do individualized types of programs for them. So my two kids right now, they are finishing up last year's Abeka. So that means that my eighth grader now is finishing up Abeka 7, and my fourth grader is finishing up Abeka 3. And I'm gonna show you guys how I kind of just organize all of this stuff to keep it all together. So this is Language Arts 3, the teacher's manual. Now I know this is like super thick, this thing is a little bit heavy, so forgive me if I have to keep putting it down, but inside the Language Arts 3 for Abeka, and I'm making sure I have everything here, we have language, which includes grammar, sentence structure, those type of things, reading comprehension, spelling, handwriting, poetry, and all of the readers that are down here. This is also the teacher's manual that has the art and what is this? Songs we enjoy. We don't do the Abeka art or songs we enjoy. We just stick with the main language arts portion, and those two subjects are actually done with My Father's World. So inside we have so many things, and the edges here are perforated, which is awesome for people like me who want to put things in binders. And what I do with this is, because this is broken up into different sections, like the first section is reading and the second section is language, and then there's spelling and then handwriting, and it goes all the way from day one to day 180. So you can kind of see here how that's broken up. So this is the reading portion here. So I'm going to go through that, and I'm going to read everything that I would need. And in the very beginning, it has a lot of overview type things for you. So the beginning portion is important, and the backpack section is important for you if you've never used Abeka. So I use this in conjunction with this just to keep things a little bit easier for me. So as you can see, I printed off the front cover and I put it on here just so I can keep things a little more organized for myself. In the spelling section, the first set of spelling tests are in there, and they have one of these copies in the book, and you can just run off copies at home. And this is one of the things that I just do to keep things a little bit easier. So right in the front pocket, because for some reason it just works out better for me to keep them in the front pocket, I have printed out spelling tests 7 through 18. So the spelling test for week 7 through 18 will use this sheet. And there's vocabulary at the bottom, and then there's the spelling words at the top where you do the dictation. So with that, I just print off however many I need, and then what I do is, once I have the 12 or 14 of them that I need, I will go ahead and hole punch them and put them right in the front pocket, so every Friday I can just pick one out and we're done. Then in the front section, if you plan on reselling your Abeka curriculum book, Here's the thing. You might not want to rip the pages out. So what I do, because I have two kids and sometimes I resell and sometimes I don't, it depends on the cycle that you might be in, because Abeka updates a new grade every year right now. I don't know if it's always like this, but ever since we've used Abeka, they've been upgrading. So my son, my youngest son, he is in this cycle where the grade above him is the one that's always being done next. That's just where he fell. And they go in order. So when he was in kindergarten, they were upgrading the first grade pack. And then when he was in first, they were upgrading second, and so on and so on. So right now he's in the third grade, and I was able to get my hands on the new third grade one because we ordered a little bit late last year. So I have a new one. So I can resell this if I want, and I can get a good price for it instead of selling an older one. So what you can do is, in the back they have these sheets and they are the progress reports. Now they are in the appendix section, and it will have everything that you need. And I'm gonna try to show you what this looks like. They will have reports for every day, or well, for every section of the curriculum. And it will have all of the places for you to record your grade. These are so handy, and I have never used another curriculum that has a progress report so well done like this, because it even tells you like the test number, the lesson, which is the day that you would be doing the test or the assignment, and then the grade, and then it has, you know, an area where you can put the grade. And it makes grading so much easier for me when I need to do grading. So I love those, and I actually use those. So what you can do is you can run them off, or you can pull them out if you want. I go ahead and I just run mine off so I can resell it, and I put them right in the front so they're super easy to find. So after my progress reports, that's where I start the page protectors. Now, we do the Abeka handwriting, and I can't say enough good things about the Abeka handwriting. My third grader has better handwriting than I do, and I was a teacher, and I really wish I had Abeka handwriting when I was a kid. He's been doing cursive since first grade, and he really loves doing cursive. So he uses these quite often, and sometimes I will let him just use this and he can use a dry erase marker or whatever he wants. And other times he just needs to see it. At this point, he's not at the point where he needs to trace it anymore. He just needs to see it and sometimes have a refresher during handwriting time. So I have a copy of that. So that's their cursive formation guide. And then in the appendix, there are sentence strips once you get up to third grade. I go ahead and I just pulled those out instead of copying all of them because I was lazy. These are all the sentence strips. So when it tells me in the book for the language arts section that I need sentence strips 1, 2, and 5, and 10, then I can just go in here and I can pull out the pages that I need, and they're just right here. And I will probably just put these in a little binder clip and put it inside here when I resell it. Next, we have the language charts. And once he got to third grade, we really started using these charts. When you're in kindergarten through second grade, you use things like you use more phonics cards. There were too many phonics cards for me to really do that. So I would always just have those stacked near my teacher's manual, and we would just use the boxes that it came in. They're really sturdy and nice boxes. But once we got to three, there was enough to where I could just pull them out of the box that they came in, and I just put a page protector. I put each one in a page protector, and these have held up really well throughout the year, and we have just been using it like this. Super easy, super simple, and we can pull it out of the notebook when we're using it and put it on the board, or he can put it next to his desk. He can use it to help him memorize his helping verbs or whatever he's doing. I have some extra page protectors here, and then in the back I just have writing paper, because sometimes we use the board and sometimes we don't. Once they get to about third grade, or well, really in second grade, I think we did this too, they'll have you start the sentence structure. So you're going to be starting learning subjects and predicates, where to divide those, and they really, in fourth grade, will start the how to really deconstruct the sentence and starting that. Now, with that, because we go through a lot of stuff on the board, we actually do that on paper sometimes rather than the board, because it's just easier sometimes for me just to write it out and it's quicker. So that is a look inside of my Abeka binder, and I hope that that helps you guys out if you're looking for a way to organize this curriculum for the upcoming year. We have really, really enjoyed this, and Abeka is by far my favorite language arts program. They are so much fun, and the younger grades are just so colorful. And as you can see from this chart, they're just full of color and pictures, and it just, my kids have done so well with their program, with their reading program especially. If you guys have any questions, feel free to pop it down below and I will get to them as soon as I can. I hope you guys have a great rest of your day and I will see you in the next video.